first 30 minutes here. Today I have a quick video on how to play LSPDFR on the latest Grand Theft Auto 5 update. So as many of you are aware, there was an update for Grand Theft Auto 5 today. And in the past, when you have an update, it completely disables your Rage plugin hook, your script hook V. They won't work on the latest update of the game. And there's some lag time between when those mods get updated so you can use them and when the update for Grand Theft Auto 5 comes out. So you can do this really easy trick to revert back and you'll still have your functionality of playing LSPDFR. You don't have to worry about it. So the first thing I would recommend doing is making a folder called 1868.1. That is the version we're gonna be reverting back to. You can see I've already done it here, but in this folder, you're gonna put these files, gta5.exe, the language select, gta5launcher.exe, and play.gta5.exe. All those are in your main directory of your game. The next thing you're gonna do is go into your update folder and you're gonna copy update.rpf and you're gonna paste it in this 1868 folder. After that, you'll simply let the game update. And when it's done updating, you're gonna grab those same exact files from the directory. So once again, gta5.exe, language select, the launcher, and play gta5.exe. You're gonna label this folder 2060. That's the newest game version as of this video. You're also gonna go into your update folder and copy and paste the new update.rpf. The other thing I do is when the new DLCs come out, I'll go into updates, X64 DLC packs, and the new update is patch day 23NG. I just like to have a backup of that file, so I go ahead and put it in the 2060 folder. The next step you're gonna need to do is go back into your 1868.1 folder, and you're going to copy and paste these four files over into the directory, and then you're going to go to update.rpf and go ahead, copy and paste the 1868 update.rpf over the newest version of it. The only caveat is you have to do this before you update because you need these 1868.1 files. If you didn't, you're gonna be out of luck. This is a really easy method to do anytime the game updates. Backups are king. I always recommend having backups of everything. That way, if something ever breaks, you always can revert back. All right, you can see we're in GTA 5 now. Let's pull up our F4 menu, load plugin, and we'll test LSPDFR here really quickly. If I can type it in. And we'll see if it loads up. All right, there's our character, Officer Carson. What we're gonna do now is go ahead and force duty, make sure that is functioning. Loading right into the uniform perfectly. You can see all our call packs loading as well. Not seeing any issue here. So that is how you play LSPDFR on GTA 5's latest update. Hopefully that helped you. If it did, leave a like on the video and tell me so in the comment section below. And we'll catch you guys on the next patrol. We'll be right back.